Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how you can fake an isometric or axonometric or parallel line rendering using Lumion. All right, so I've imported a file here from the 3D warehouse. I've added a few trees and some buildings in the background, and I've also put in this little beach. Just to give it a little bit more context, because it feels weird when these things are sort of sitting in an open plane. but let's say you wanted to make a parallel line rendering of this using Lumion. That's an option you can do in Sketchup, but unfortunately when you get to Lumion, there's no option for doing those sort of types of renderings. Actually, I used to do this when I was doing some stuff with the game Quake. I was doing work for a company called Quake Live TV, and so to get all the maps, I would turn the FOV, the field of view, down really low, and zoom way out. I'd like go to a top view of the map using the spectator mode, and zoom way out, put the field of view super down, and it would give you sort of like this parallel look. So the way that you do that. Something similar in Lumion is you start with your photo. So let's say this is kind of the view that we want. You want to store your camera just so that you have that. And then what you're going to do is you're going to want to turn the focal length all the way up. That's going to zoom in a whole lot. But then what you're going to do is you're going to hold right click, and I'm pressing the S key to zoom out. And then if you also hold shift while you do that, it'll go a little bit faster. You can see the shadows get kind of weird in this mode. It sort of depends on the scale. So you may have to mess with the scale of your model just so that the shadows aren't so wonky when you do this. But so you just sort of wait a little bit. It'll take some time. But you can see as this starts to reveal the actual model, the lines look pretty parallel. So it's a really cool sort of way to get the axonometric view. If you want to do a realistic rendering or something like that of one of your projects. So if I go out some more, you can see we get the water here, and I'll just store that here so you can see the difference. This is the perspective view. This is the axonometric view. And again, like I said, you just may have to come in and mess with some of the settings in here. Maybe the scale you'll have to mess with. Another thing that I like to do is just before I go back, if you hit build, you'll see how far away I really am. If I go back to photo, just if you need to edit anything, make sure you have another photo saved so you can go into that. And then when you hit build, you'll be at that closer view. So you need to change. If you need to change any materials or anything, it makes it much easier to do having a different view saved. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.